Sam Eaplesvox back here with the Intel Streamers Bootcamp, and today we're going to talk about the benefits of investing in a multi-core processor like the Intel Core i7 processor series for higher quality video content, streaming, gaming, and video production. Let's get started. Multi-core processors are great for heavy computing tasks like batch photo editing, video encoding, HD streaming, and 4K gaming. In my opinion, Intel Core i7 processors are the best desktop options on the market. All these processors feature Intel hyperthreading technology, which uses processor resources more efficiently, enabling multiple threads to run on each core. Basically, you can run demanding applications simultaneously while maintaining system responsiveness and performance. You get to do more for your power. If you're like me and stream in HD, play 4K games, encode videos, all simultaneously, this innovative technology is a real game changer. Multicores also help a lot when I'm editing my video content. Most people will experience a lag in performance when compressing large video files. Before I switched to Intel Core i7 processors, encoding videos just meant it was time to get up from the computer and do something else. While that may still be a good idea if you haven't taken a break in a while, I'm no longer forced to do this. In Vegas Pro, I generally recommend rendering to a MP4 file with one of the available H.264 encoders. My favorite rendering setup is this one. While the encoding process takes some decent CPU power to encode, with the right settings, such as a bitrate of 18 to 26 megabits per second for 1080p 60fps videos, it helps keep your video files small while maintaining great quality for your viewers. Make sure you hit disable resample on your clips if you're mixing frame rates, or your video will look a little ghosty. Thankfully, they've now baked this option into the default project setting, so as long as you change resample mode to disable resample and check start all projects with these settings, you shouldn't have to worry about it again. While you're there, make sure your field order is set to none progressive scan, unless you're specifically creating interlaced video, that full resolution render quality is set to best, and if you have a dedicated graphics card in your system, set the interlace method to smart adaptive. Other ways you can speed up Vegas involve changing the pre-rendered files folder here, the recorded files folder in the audio tab, and the temporary files folder under preferences to a secondary scratch and cache SSD. This keeps it away from your operating system drive to keep it from filling it up, provides an easy directory for you to delete all those junk files in between projects, and can speed up your projects quite a bit. What a difference the combination of multi-core processing and hyper-threading technology makes. As you can see, when I start compressing, my PC continues to perform, and I'm easily able to switch between video editing tasks and other programs or my favorite games without delay. Heck, sometimes I'll even stream some gameplay while my video's in code, something I would have never dreamed about before. With this level of processing power, I can save myself a lot of time and get back to doing the things I like, instead of waiting around for a file to render, which is no fun. Having multiple cores and threads can really take your gaming and content creation experience to another level. Plus, if the render is affecting your performance, you can go to your task manager, click the Details tab, and then find Vegas Pro, or your video rendering or whatever task it is, right click and hit Set Affinity, and only yet let it use half of your threads. With hyperthreading, you have a lot to work with, so you can still give your render plenty of power and reserve the rest for the fun stuff. That's it for this video. For more Intel Streamers Bootcamp videos, take a look at the links at the end of this video and in the description below. Check back often for newly released topics on how to better your streaming and creator experiences. I'm Eaplesvox, and I'll see you next time.